Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose we have multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So friends, we have a series which is referred by the name Daily Answer Writing Series, in which what we do, we daily give you a certain number of questions of which you have to write the answers. So many students are aware of that, and many students are also following this series, and there are students that those students who have not subscribed to this series but are following this series. So there was a demand coming from those students ki sir, please upload the model answers also of those questions which you provide for answer writing practice. So we decided in that way that we will do, we daily upload one model answer, because here to discuss all the answers will be difficult in a video. So for that matter, we will be uploading only one answer, but that will be in a way that you will get a comprehensive idea about the topic as well as how to approach the question. So today's question is examining the role played by agriculture sector in greenhouse gas emissions. What challenges are posed by such release of greenhouse gases, and how can these challenges be addressed? So here the demand of the question is to examine that whether the agriculture sector is playing the role in greenhouse gas emissions or not, and also if it is, then what are the challenges in such release, and how can these challenges be addressed. So here we will be looking at the issue entirely from the agriculture sector, from the viewpoint of agriculture sector. So before starting the answer, let me tell you friends that as we are referring to this answer as model answer, but let me tell you that we are saying this as model answer because the students have the habit to say please provide model answers, but let me inform you, there is no model answer in UPSC. Every answer has its own we can say positives and negatives. So we can't say that a particular question is a model answer. Certainly the basic thing must be covered in the question. That question you can say that it is close to model answer, but had it been that the model answer has been the case, then the toppers would have scored 100% marks, and they also score just 50 to 55% marks. So let's start our discussion. So friends, Secretary General of United Nations Antonio Guterres believes that climate change, which is happening all around, basically due to the greenhouse gas emissions, his contention is that if it is progressing faster than we are. So according to him, the pace of climate change is faster than us. So and if nothing is done to control this situation by 2020, it would have disastrous consequences for human beings as well as all natural systems that are there in the earth, over the earth, sorry. So climate change is in fact it is a fact, and it impacts all facets of human civilization, whether it is health, family, income, livelihood, security, agriculture production. So for example, climate change, due to climate change, disastrous events takes place, so that impacts all health. And also climate change, for example, if climate change is reducing the productivity of your agriculture, then it is compromising your income also, income of the farmer also, and it is endangering his livelihood also. And in a way, he uses more pesticides and fertilizers, and then these fertilizers also contribute to greenhouse gas emissions. So these impact your health also, because chemicals are used in agriculture practice. So there is an interlinkage. So health, family, income, livelihood, security, whether that is food security or internal security for that matter. You might be kind of surprised that how it can impact internal security. Certainly if the family income of the people is affected, if people are suffering, then they are losing their livelihoods, and their kind of agony will find an expression in a certain way. So that creates internal problems. Then there is agriculture production, crops, livestock and fisheries, and then international trade. rate. So multiple things are there. So here we have to simply you have to give small introduction. So this is not the ideal introduction, but you have to reduce it into word limit. We are providing you the answer from the viewpoint of comprehensive coverage, so you can reduce it as per your as per the demand of the question and as per your convenience. And then there is role of agriculture in greenhouse gases. So friends, it is mainly ignored that greenhouse gases are also produced by the agriculture sector, because there has been an estimation that out of the total emissions that are human caused, so not the word human caused, so to out of the total emissions, 10 to 12% are attributable to agriculture. So it is a large amount, and thus agriculture is not just the victim of the climate change, but is also an active abater. Passive abater if not an active. So also we can say active also. So to reduce the footprint of agriculture relative to climate change, it is necessary to understand how this sector contributes to greenhouse gases. So friends, first of all, an important thing is that significant amounts of carbon dioxide is released by the decomposition of soil organic matter. So when in the soil there is organic matter, so when its decomposition takes place, carbon dioxide is released into the atmosphere, which is a greenhouse gas. And then there is a burning of crop residue, especially in the northwestern part of India. It is a major concern, and it also contributes to air pollution. It contributes to the emission of carbon dioxide, which is a greenhouse gas. And also then there is usage of fossil fuels in the agriculture. For example, there is coal and natural gas used for example irrigation pumps, or you can say for in tractors. So all these contribute to different greenhouse gases. And then there is a very other thing, very important thing, is that methane is also produced in flooded rice fields. So flooded rice fields are a kind of a source for methane. So methane is produced in large quantities in these rice fields. So in addition, then there is gut flora in cattle. So that is methanogens. So they produce methane as a bioproduct in the process of enteric fermentation, that is fermentation in the intestine of the animals. So this is ultimately belched out by the cattle, and this contributes to addition of methane into the atmosphere. So other thing is that there is also nitrous oxide, which is produced by microbial processes. So microbial processes are continuing in the soil, and then this activity also happens in manures. So also other very important factor that is attributable to human activity is excess use of nitrogen fertilizers. So friends, you might be aware that the use of fertilizers in especially the northwestern part of India or West UP is high to increase the productivity. You can also say to productivity and also to increase the production, because soil the soil health is decreasing and then the productivity is reducing, and then to realize the full potential, nitrogen fertilizers are applied often in an unscientific way, nitrous oxide is a greenhouse gas, and it contributes to the green agricultural generated greenhouse gas emissions. So now innovative solutions are certainly required, but we will look at these solutions at later on. But first of all, we will see what are the challenges and consequences that are posed by these greenhouse gases. So first of all, let me tell you friends that most important staple crops in India are wheat and rice. So majority of the India either consume wheat or rice. So there is scientists have found that if the temperature increases, heat stress increases, or for that matter carbon dioxide in atmosphere increases, then there is a stress on the food crops, and then this reduces the food grain production. So if there is a reduction in food grain production, then there is certainly issue of food security, which means access and affordability and availability of food, because availability availability, accessibility and affordability, all three things will be compromised by the reduction in this food grain production. So according to United Nations Food and Agricultural Organization, so it has found that if in India temperature increases by 1 degree, there will be a reduction in the wheat production by 6 million tons. So you can see the large quantity of wheat that annually that will not be produced annually due to this in 1 degree increase in temperature. So in monetary terms, it costs nearly $1.5 billion. So it is a quite large amount. And similarly, scientists from the Indian Institute for Rice International Rice Research Institute have found that if the temperature increases, that will also make an impact on the rice production, because rice production will impact 10% will be reduced by 10% if there is a 1 degree rise in temperature. So and also then if we see India's annual loss for all crops, then the loss is quite very large. So you can see that if a Food and Agriculture Organization of United Nations say that 1 degree rise in temperature could lead to a loss that could be in monetary terms be $20 billion. So it is a quite large amount. So it is it will be lost annually. So you can see how the economic potential of the country will be compromised and its GDP will be reduced. And then there is 2 degree rise Celsius rise also. There is a threat of 2 degree Celsius rise in average temperature, which will make India's monsoons highly unpredictable. And you all know that for agriculture, our majority of our farmers depend upon monsoons, and also monsoons play an important role in entire we can say biogeochemical cycle. So and if there is a high unpredictability in India's monsoons, then water security will also be compromised, and the droughts will be there, and especially in northwestern part of India. So here we can say if we see the Punjab example. So if Punjab, it is said that by 2050 the Punjab's the state of Punjab will experience an average rise of temperature by 2.5 degrees Celsius, which would be kind of a disastrous consequence for food production, as the state produces more than 20% of India's wheat and 10% of country's rice. So you can see how the food security is compromised. It in a nutshell you can say that it will be adversely impacted. And then there is now an obscure consequence of climate change which has recently come to light. So it was not kind of much known, but scientists have also found that the crops like wheat, maize and soybean and peas, which are a kind of important source of nutrition for Indian people, when they are grown in heat stress and high carbon dioxide conditions, there was a reduced amount of protein in them, and then carbon dioxide, protein, and then also zinc. And the reduction in protein, zinc and iron. So this you can see how it can impact. And then there is it has been found that B vitamins were reduced by as much as 30% in the 18 strains of rice that were grown under high temperature and high carbon dioxide conditions. So also crop pollination will be affected, because when plants will be exposed to high carbon dioxide levels, the nectar will not be released in that much amount, and also then there is the pollens in them will not get proper nutrition or protein, and then that will ultimately affect the bees. So this is the major problem. Also then there is also problem of rise of population. So India's population is expected to reach 1.7 billion in 2050. So now currently if we make a rough estimate, then 2020 population is 1.39 billion, up close to 1.4 billion. So there will be a 0.3 billion rise of India's population, and that rise in population will require a huge amount of food production. Certainly now, as of now, we produce annually 270 million tons of food. So increased population would require the increased food grain production. That is, close to 400 more million tons of food will be required. That amounts to nearly 670. So you can say that 700 million tons of food grain production will be required by 2050 to meet the food needs of India's population. So that is a major issue then, because as productivity will reduce because of the increased temperature and increased carbon dioxide conduction concentration in atmosphere, because it will cause greenhouse effect, and then this will compromise the productivity of the crops, and then certainly there will be more usage of nitrogen fertilizers to sustain and increase the productivity, and this will further increase the agricultural contributions to greenhouse gas emissions. So you might say that the current contributions, which are 10 to 12%, they might go 15 to 20% also. So that is a major issue, because there is a clear conflict. You can say that you can see that population will increase and the food grain production will decrease due to increasing temperature, and then there will be more additional use of nitrogen fertilizers, and then that will further increase the greenhouse gas concentration in atmosphere, hastening the climate change. So World Bank also estimated that India might need to import more than twice the amount of food grains than would be required without climate change by the year 2050. So for example, if in 2050 if climate change doesn't happen, we would be required to import 200 million tons of food grain, then with climate change the amount will be 400 million tons. So that will certainly be a big cost on our exchequer also, and that will be that is a major cause of concern. And then what measures can be taken to address the challenge? Now let's see what are the steps that we can take. So obviously the most important suggestion is invest in climate smart agriculture. So what do you mean by climate smart agriculture? So climate smart agriculture is that agriculture which sustainably kind of increases production and enhances resilience, that is adaptation, and reduces or removes greenhouse gases. So obviously climate smart agriculture must also be carbon neutral agriculture, so that also demands a reduction and removal of greenhouse gases wherever possible. And achievement and the main goal also should be of national food security. And then there so friends, let's see, we will be covering this aspect in two parts, that is mitigation of climate change and mitigation strategies, and then adaptation strategies. So what do you mean by mitigation? So mitigation is basically a strategy in which what you do, you kind of avoid the unmanageable. So a situation that is unmanageable by you, then you will you try to avoid it. So that is the mitigation approach. And then there is the adaptation approach, which is basically managing the unavoidable. So which is unavoidable and we have to manage it, and it is must that we manage it smartly. So mitigation strategies, we can say, become carbon neutral by 2050. Carbon neutral, you might be knowing the fact. So these are the small facts that will be covered in any book of the environment. For example, Shankar IAS environment book, please go through such books. So then stabilize greenhouse gas emissions within 20 years. So it is important that now the greenhouse gas gas emissions are increasing, but now we have to stabilize them, and within 20 years with 2% reduction per year thereafter. So it is a very it seems very normal, but it is a challenging task, and it demands serious effort. So this point is very important. So please note this point, and please keep it in mind that emissions have to be stabilized and then have to be reduced at the rate of 2% per year thereafter. And then you must shift to we must shift to low carbon green economy, we can say. And then other thing is avoid using fossil fuels and incentivize use of renewable energy in agriculture. For example, avoid using coal and natural gas or petrol, then you shifting to solar power, biofuels. And then there must also be reduction in area under rice from 27 lakh to 15 lakh hectares, because rice fields produce methane. And then under adaptation strategies, the major ones are that scientists must identify the various types of genes that are adaptive to this we can say this stress, that is heat stress or carbon dioxide stress, by using biotechnological techniques. And then there must be also exploration of genetic resources that are there in the wild that are more kind of, we can say, more resilient to this increased heat stress, or for example carbon dioxide stress, or for future biotic or abiotic stresses, for example biotic insect pests and diseases, and then drought and salinity, because obviously Earth is a kind of home to a huge variety of genetic resources, and they must be identified. And then there must also be focused on the enhancing of the nutritional value of staple crops, because certainly as I've told you that in the Food Agriculture Organization has said that the production will reduce, and also then scientists found that there will be reduction in the nutrients in the, we can say, protein, iron and zinc. And then there must be focus on the biofortification, so that the loss in the important ingredients of the crop they that must be covered. So because malnutrition or other ill effects associated with poor nutrition can be avoided. And then there must be we should follow carbon sequestration, and then by shifting to crops with high carbon storage, and then reduce forest clearing for agricultural expansion, because forests are kind of, we can say, carbon sink, are a kind of carbon sink in which carbon is stored in trees for a long time. So there must also be adaptation of conservation and precision agriculture. For example, conservation and precision agriculture means using fertilizers in a precise manner, not wasting anything. Then there must also be practice of agroforestry, so that crops and trees must be grown together, so that if there is a production of carbon dioxide in soil, or for that matter by the crop, then trees take them up and store in them. And then there must be preservation of wetlands, because they are 3 to 5 times more carbon. They have the kind of, we can say, efficiency of storing carbon 3 to 5 times more than the forest trees. And also there must be incentivization for efficient use of groundwater resources. And there must also be development of cattle feeds that reduce methane emissions. And then we should focus on improving of fertilizer use efficiency of crops. And there must also be concerned institutions that should conduct cutting edge research to combat this problem of climate change, and this research must also be interdisciplinary, and there should be porous walls between the disciplines. So, and then we can say that Albert Einstein once said that the significant problems we face cannot be solved at the same level of thinking we used when we created them. So this quote is very important in concluding. So this is all about today's question. So you can see that this single question has taken 22 minutes. So certainly it is difficult for covering all the questions. So you might have become aware of this issue. If you like the question, then do ensure that you like it. And if you want to join our series, that is this series of daily mains answer writing, then you can join using this link. And you can also contact us if you have any queries regarding our daily answer writing practice. That is, you can mail us at achieveias21@gmail.com, or you can also contact us at our contact number, that is 8968920720. So there are many benefits of joining this series. That is, daily 5 questions will be given to you, 3 questions will be from your current topics, and 2 from your static topics, and comprehensive evaluation of answers will be done by the experts that we have in our team. So then also reference materials of all the questions will be provided to you. For example, in this question, in today's questions, you got the model answer of only one question. Then if in case you join us, then you will be provided the model answers for all the questions, and it is least costly, and you can also join on a monthly basis. So link will be provided in the description box, so you can join using that link. So thank you, friends. This is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day.